Hello.
Hello.
We've recently been on a little bit of a holiday. Call it a holiday?
Yeah, it was a holiday.
It was real fun. It was more of an excursion.
It was.
I'd call
it
an excursion.
So we had a holiday called Golden Week, where the whole of China is on holiday for a week. James was lucky enough to have a week off,
as
was I. During Golden Week, I think it was, 6 billion people?
No, that's the whole of the world.
6 million people travelling?
No, 600 million.
Yeah, it's a lot,
600 million people in Asia were travelling
during Golden Week. So it was crazy. So we decided not to go anywhere. So we spent the first couple of days in Shanghai. However, we thought that we better had explore a bit more of China, really. So we booked onto a tour called
Wanna Travel.
Yeah, Wanna Travel.
And it was called the Oxygen Bar.
Yeah, the Oxygen Bar Tour.
Yeah, which consisted of 3 days of activities, really, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. So we went to a place called Panan Province, which is about 5 or 6 hour drive west of Shanghai.
Yeah. No, it's not
west, yeah.
It's south.
Southwest.
Oh, don't know.
Okay, more fun facts.
I say southeast.
Right, anyway, into the countryside, basically. So when we arrived, we checked into our hotel, which was a proper Chinese guest house. It was lovely, wasn't it? It was really,
really
nice and
nice.
Clean. We then went off to an ancient town, which was amazing to see. Some of these buildings had been built more dates.
How many?
Had been built a really long time ago.
What date are you saying?
Had been built a really long time ago. And it was really nice to see some proper Chinese architecture, because in and around Shanghai, it's very,
very modern.
Yeah, it's very modern.
After we'd been to the ancient town, me and Becca had a little wander. Becca had photos with more Chinese people.
Yeah, they were really nice. And we had whole families just sort of wandering
around.
Yeah, following us around the village. And sort of amazed at the fact that there were two Westerners having a look around. But everybody was so nice, weren't they?
Really nice. We walked past one woman and she had a bowl out and it was like just sitting outside her house. And she was like looking up at us with the chopsticks, like as if saying, do you want to eat?
Yeah.
And I swear she had nothing herself,
no,
did she?
It was really, really humbling, wasn't it?
It was. So after that we went and made dumplings.
Yeah.
We got to actually make them and do all the little folds they do. Yeah, it was quite difficult, wasn't it? There's definitely a knack to it.
There is. I didn't have it.
So the next morning, I woke up really early because there was like a market going on outside. I could hear Becca was up, but somehow Becca managed to fall asleep. I go outside and there's like all these old women all like marveling at me. I then went for a wander and found all these like really nice buildings, and it was like down by a river and...
wasn't it?
Yeah, just the scenery was fabulous. I got to see the sunrise. Yeah, it was great.
I didn't see any of this, I was asleep.
I know, good. So I got off for breakfast then as well.
Did you?
Yeah, by random old guys. But then that day, we did something I'd never usually do. It was a zip line, but it wasn't just any zip line,
It's pretty epic, really, wasn't it?
It was, yeah.
It was as far as the eye could see. There wasn't much to it, really, was there? There wasn't... Health and safety isn't in the forefront.
Of anyone's mind, here?
No, in China. No, it's not a big thing, really. However, we were very scared.
I was very scared. But I was watching them do it, and I was like, they're hooking the like top of the line on, and I'm just thinking, there's no way of it coming off, but...
There's always that little bit of doubt.
Yeah, isn't there?
Mm. Anyway, it was amazing. We saw some incredible views.
Check them out. We'll be right back. then went and walked across like a glass bridge, which was quite fun. We were trying to get photos like lying down on it, but
it just wasn't happening.
You just get a reflection of the sky. Yeah. Mm. But that was quite fun. But it would have been better if we'd done it the other way around, because
adrenaline afterwards.
Yeah, after doing the most scary bit, you're not bothered about walking across a bridge, are you? The afternoon we went, that was when we went on the hike. God, the hike was crazy. It was through green tea terraces.
Yeah, it was beautiful.
And it was pretty epic, like the scenery.
We just seemed to be going up and up and up and up and up and up. For hours.
We were literally having to
battle through bushes.
Yeah, it was very overgrown, and it was this old guy who actually was the guy who owned the B&B. Took us this way. He was wearing suit trousers.
Yeah, just normal like suit shoes. We were there like suited and booted, hiking gear, rucksack, the lot, and he just wasn't bothered.
No.
But again, it was absolutely beautiful. People that we came across were really, really nice. And we had a great day, didn't we?
Yeah, it was a really nice day. So the last day we got up early again. We all got on the bus.
Yeah, it was where we ended the hike. It was like a big river gorge. Walk across a really big bridge, and then the
rope bridge.
Yeah, it's a rope bridge.
And I felt like Indiana Jones.
There's like a walkway built onto the side of the cliff.
Oh God, yeah.
But you don't really realise the fact that you're walking on the edge of a cliff. Well, until you sort of look over the edge and realise there's not very much supporting you
when
underneath.
When you see it like in front, yeah. This is a bit, I wouldn't normally want to do things like that either. But it was, you know.
James the adrenaline junkie over here.
Yeah, far from it. It was just.
But again, it was beautiful. We walked all around the edge of the cliff. We got so far, and then there was a water slide that you could go down on, and that was so weird. Much fun. Once again, health and safety non-existent.
No.
Bashing into the corners full throttle.
Full throttle.
Full throttle. Full power. Yeah. And again, it was fantastic. Then we finished off on a bamboo boat.
Bamboo boat, and they use bamboo for everything here, and you can also eat it, and it's
great.
Yeah.
Well, why not? There's loads of it.
Well, yeah, true. Because that's actually what we walked through in the end, isn't it?
Yeah. So the bamboo boat was really, really nice. And then we finished off by having some pictures by like a little waterfall. And then we went back to Shanghai, didn't we?
Yeah.
So we had an amazing time. We met some really nice people. Some of them we've seen since, and I'm sure we'll see more of them in the future, won't we?
Definitely.
So yeah, definitely check out Wanna Travel. We'll put the link in the description below. They do some amazing trips all across China. They do them to Tibet as well. And,
what do they do them to?
Tibet as well, and they don't break the bank either. They are cheap and cheerful.
Yeah.
And you get an English speaking guide as well, and they speak Mandarin as well, so it's also really helpful.
Yeah, it was a great trip, and we'll be doing more trips with them again.
Yeah.
Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, check out our Instagram, and you can keep up to date with us there.
Bye.
Bye. The big city life.
Yeah, and also it doesn't break the bank either. It's
Sorry, you can't do it. Just because I was singing it all weekend, wasn't I? Sorry, carry on.
Big city life, trying to get by.